Okay, go.
Baruchim habayim chevra. Welcome everybody to this amazing event in Toronto and Thornhill, Canada, and all around the world. We are so excited and so happy to be part of this event, which is, I'm told, the 18th class in the series of live classes given by the Rav Shalom Arush. And since it's the 18th class and we're together with Toronto, Canada, we're calling it Chai with Toronto. It's the 18th class together with Toronto. And Baruch Hashem, I've been speaking to everybody from Breslev.co.il, and they've been telling me how excited they are to be connected with the Toronto community, and how much they love to speak to us, and how much they love to be mechazek us, to give us strength, and to have this connection. And we feel, here in Toronto and Thornhill, so excited and so happy to be connected as well. So happy to hear the Torah of Rav Arush, and so happy to have meetings and personal discussions and chizuk from Rav Arush. We appreciate it so much. Today's class is going to be titled Aliyah and Mashiach. And before we get to the class, I just want to say a couple words of introduction to my relationship with Rav Arush and the Toronto relationship to Rav Arush.
Gamani Samea.
I'm also very happy to meet you and to meet everyone. Thank Hashem, we meet once a week. We already have students who are permanent and who see us every single week and join our shiurim. And now we're delighted to be with you, Rabbi Gislason, and we're going to speak about the subjects that you want to be speaking about, Mashiach and Aliyah.
Amazing, amazing. So just a couple of points before we get right into the discussion. There's going to be, I want to introduce, I've been told, a new campaign, which is going to be called the Buy Just One Book campaign. And it's going to be coming soon. And the idea of this is that everyone who has a connection to Rav Arush and who feels that Rav Arush has helped them and changed their lives and given them strength and Emuna will buy one book and find a person that they love, that they care about, that needs help, that needs chizuk, and give this book to them. Hashkacha Pratis, I happen to be opening the Kutei Moran today to Torah Yud Dalet, which is the next Torah that we're learning in our Chabura in Toronto. And the following words are in Torah Yud Dalet Likutei Moran. V'yif shar lahalo yis hakavoy, ela al yedei Torah chesed. We cannot lift up and elevate the honor of Hashem, the kavod of Hashem, except through Torah chesed, the Torah of chesed, the Torah of kindness. What is Torah chesed, says Rabbi Nachman? But Torah chesed, amru chachamin zvan lebracha, Chazal say in the Gemara and Sukkah, zehu haloymed Torah al manas lelamda. That's a person who learns Torah for the purpose of teaching it over to someone else. And the reason is because the biggest honor that can be given to the name of Hashem in the world, says the Zohar, like by Yisro, is when someone who's far away from Hashem, in their opinion, comes close to Hashem. Someone who's not close to Emuna learns to have Emuna and grows in Emuna and grows in Torah and their connection to Hashem. So this new campaign that's going to be happening, where we're all going to take a book, take one of Universal Garden of Emuna, and we take one of these books and we find a person who we feel we can help, we can make a change in their lives. What a beautiful idea coming right from the words of Rabbi Nachman, and something that we can all be part of. We've all, to some extent, been touched by the Torah of Rav Arush and the way that he brings down the deep concepts of Rabbi Nachman and puts them into our hearts and gives us the ability to really live with them and to really grow with those tremendously holy teachings. So I want to thank once again the Rav Arush for having such an effect on us, for planting that Torah into my heart and for changing my life and for changing the lives of so many other people. I would like to introduce Rav Shalom Arush, and he will be being translated by Dayan Elgrod, and I look forward to hearing every single word from this special presentation and to continuing our connection. This year is every single Sunday at approximately 1:30, and we can all connect all over the world. We also have, everybody should know, we have shiurim weekly, many shiurim here in Breslev of Thor Hill in Toronto that can be accessed by Zoom and Bezuz Hashem. We should all be together strong and enjoying our connection and growing in Emuna together from the words, the holy words of Rav Arush. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward.
Amen. Thank you.
אז הבנתי את התורה היהודה, אז הבנתי את העניין הזה שהוא ממש שיבע, את העניין הזה שבתורה הראש עובר דרכי, בתורת חסד וכו'. מעשה, מה הוא רוצה שדבר ראשון לחזק? את העניין של ארץ ישראל, מה הוא רוצה?
כן, כבוד הרב.
כן.
הוא רוצה עכשיו שיחזקו. The Rav is now saying that he appreciates and he thanks you and he understood what you said about Torah Yudalet. About what Rabbeinu says about teaching, learning in order to teach. And with the help of Hashem, we'll be strengthening you today on the two issues, the important issues of Aliyah and of Mashiach. First and foremost, I am delighted, extremely happy that you actually want to speak about this important subject of Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael. People always used to tell me, don't speak to people who live abroad about Aliyah.
אז ברוך השם שיש כבר התעוררות ורצון לעלות לישראל, זהו.
Thank Hashem, there's already an awakening and a desire to make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael.
באמת, 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 כל מי שיש לו יראת שמיים.
Really and truly, everyone who is a God-fearing person, who has Yiras Shemaim, that he preserves and he keeps the Torah and the mitzvahs, if he would make Aliyah and come to Eretz Yisrael, certainly all these people would bring the Geula much more speedily to come as close as we can imagine. Because we need to give the power of the Torah. That here in Eretz Yisrael, the power is the power of Torah. We don't need to fight anyone. We could have easily made sure that Eretz Yisrael would be a land of Torah.
ולכן, הגמרא בכתובות, שם יש כמעט 3 דפים, בבית מעניין של מה זה המעלה לגור בארץ ישראל.
In the Gemara, Tractate Ketubos, there are at least 3 pages which talk about the great virtue of living in Eretz Yisrael.
ואחד הדברים, מה החזקים ביותר שכבר, שכתוב שם בגמרא.
One of the strongest things that's written there in the Gemara.
שאפילו יותר טוב לגור פה בארץ ישראל, אפילו בעיר שכולה גויים, מאשר לגור בחוץ לארץ בעיר שכולה יהודים.
The Gemara says it is better to live in Eretz Yisrael, even in a city that is mostly the people living there, mostly inhabited by non-Jews, than living in Chutz Laretz, in a city which is completely Jewish. This is the Torah. The Gemara is the Torah of Am Yisrael. In the Gemara, it is written what Hashem wants. So no one can be smarter and say that he understands that Hashem's will is for him to live in Chutz Laretz.
אז הגמרא אומרת שמי שגר בחוץ לארץ דומה כמי שאין לו אלוהה.
The Gemara says that he who lives abroad, it is as if he doesn't have a God.
באמת, הרי מי שמאמין, כן, שיבוא משיח, מי שמאמין שיבוא משיח.
Truly, if you believe that Mashiach is coming,
אז איך אתה לא גר בארץ ישראל?
So how come you're not living here in Eretz Yisrael?
יש דבר שלי חזק מאוד 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 מאוד.
There's something that is very, 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 very strong.
שכותב אותו סנגורן של ישראל.
that the advocate of Am Yisroel writes it. Rabbi Levi Yitzchak of Baditchev, of blessed memory. He writes that when Mashiach will come,
as Yehudim shelo shem lo mash lo avdu l'argish et kedushat Eretz Yisrael.
Jews, Yidden, they didn't work on feeling the holiness, the sanctity of Eretz Yisrael.
Velo itabru al churban Eretz Yisrael.
And didn't grieve for the destruction of Eretz Yisrael.
Yavo malachim ya'ifu otam lechutz la'aretz.
When angels will come and they will cast them away abroad.
ויהודים שגרים בחוץ לארץ ולהם יכלו לעלות לארץ ישראל.
And we're talking here also about Jews in Eretz Yisrael. And on the other hand, Jews who were abroad and they did have the ability of coming here to Eretz Yisrael.
לא יתנו להם אפשרות לעלות לארץ ישראל.
The angels will not allow them to make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael.
רק, לא יראו את כל הניסים האפשרות שיהיו פה בארץ ישראל.
And they won't see all the great miracles that will happen here in Eretz Yisrael in the times of Mashiach.
רק אחרי שיהיה כבר את כל, הכל כבר פה, רק אחרי שכבר יהיה כל הניסים האפשרות וכל הטוב שיהיה פה.
Only after all the miracles occur, only after all the goodness is already set into Eretz Yisrael, only then will they be allowed to make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael. Why? Because this is an explicit Gemara. That he who does not grieve for the destruction of Jerusalem will not merit to see in its joy and happiness when it's rebuilt.
סנגרן של ישראל כותב שהעיפו יהודים מארץ ישראל, פתאום נמצא את עצמו בחוץ לארץ, אומר, מה אני עושה פה? איפה אני נמצא? עכשיו, אתה עכשיו רוצה לארץ ישראל עכשיו. רק אחרי, אתה לא תראה את כל הטוב שיהיה ליהודים, אתה לא תראה. רק אחר כך, שהכל יהיה, רק תכנס.
When I read this, I couldn't believe the protector of Am Yisrael, he who always says good things about Am Yisrael, Lev Yitzchak of Baditchev, that is what is saying, the Jews who hear in Eretz Yisrael will be cast away to Chutz Laretz. They'll wake up and say, where am I? What am I doing here? Why am I in Chutz Laretz? And I understood, because if you're not part of grieving for Eretz Yisrael and its destruction, you don't merit to see when Eretz Yisrael will be built with all the wonderful miracles in the times of Mashiach.
שלא יתאמצו לעלות לישראל, הם לא יהיה להם את הזכות לעלות לישראל בזמן הטוב הזה.
And more so, Jews who lived abroad, who had the ability to make Aliyah, but they didn't make the effort, they will not merit to be here when all this goodness, when all these miracles occur.
רבי ומורי, רבי לוי, יהודה זאב לייבוביץ'.
My mentor and teacher, Rabbi Yehuda Zev Leibovich of blessed memory,
שהוא אמר לנו בפירוש.
He told us explicitly,
תגידו ליהודים שבחוץ לארץ יעלו.
Tell the Jews in חוץ לארץ, abroad,
יעלו מהר לארץ ישראל.
To quickly and speedily make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael.
יבוא הזמן שירצו לעלות, לא יוכלו לעלות.
There'll come a time that they will want to make Aliyah, they will not be allowed to.
ואני, שנים אני שם את זה בתוך, שם את זה בבטן שלי, ואני לא אומר את זה.
For years I'm guarding this information, this knowledge inside me, and I'm not saying it to people.
כי תמיד אני מקיים את המשנה שאומרת שאם אתה יודע שלא ישמעו, אז אל תדבר.
Because I always try to keep the Mishnah that says that when you know people will not hear what you want to say, don't say it.
אני שמח שעכשיו פעם ראשונה נותנים לי הזדמנות לדבר. אך, קצת, אני...
I'm happy that now this is the first time I am being given the ability to speak. I'm so happy. Thank you, Hashem, for allowing me to say what I feel.
בטח, איזה שמחה יהיה ממש לקדוש ברוך הוא, לצדיקים, לנו, לראות פה את ארץ ישראל מלאה ביהודים שעולים תורה ומצוות, וואי, וואי, וואי.
Can you imagine the joy and happiness that Hashem, the righteous people, the tzaddikim, and we will have when we see Eretz Yisrael filled with observant Jews?
זה ייתן ממש, זה ממש ייתן כוח ואור. ממש לגרש את כל החושך מארץ ישראל.
It will give strength and light to abolish all the darkness from Eretz Yisrael, to abolish all the bad, all the dark side and the evil from Eretz Yisrael.
Thank you, Hashem.
No translation needed. So this is the first point we're speaking about. If you have any questions, please, you can send it to the manager of our English program, Rabbi Eli.Goldsmith. How can they send it to you, Rabbi Eli.? All the questions, if they have any questions?
By email, by text.
You can send questions by email, by text, by every platform. We'll be happy to answer them during the year. Rabbi Gillison, is there anything you would like to ask? Rabbi, one sec. I believe I can't hear him. Rabbi Gillison, one second.
Gillison, one second. Oh. Can you hear me now? Hold on. There we go. Modern technology is good, but sometimes takes a few minutes to get it right. You can hear me now?
Yes, wonderfully. Is there anything you'd like to ask, Rabbi?
Sure. So, a lot of people will say...
You listen to me?
The Rav asks, you heard me, right?
Of course.
Yes.
Every word. Many people will say... I have a stable parnasa.
Yes, like parnasa. יש לי כאן פרנוס, הכל יציבות כאן בחוץ לארץ. ואם אני אעבור לארץ ישראל, העבודה שלי לא תעבור. אני לא יודע עברית, איך יהיה לי עבודה, איך אני אדאג למשפחה שלי.
אני יכול לספר את הסיפור של אבא שלי.
I can tell the story of my father.
אני גרתי במרוקו.
I lived in Morocco.
אנחנו עלינו בשנת 63.
We made Aliyah in 1963.
כמה זמן מאז?
We're talking here about 57 years ago.
אז 56 שנים, נכון בערך?
כן? Yeah, about approximately 56, 56, 57.
כן. אז שהאבא שלי, עליו השלום, כל כך היה, שמע שיש ארץ ישראל, יש בה יהודים, מה זה, כל הזמן מדבר, מתי על ארץ ישראל.
My father of blessed memory always spoke about making Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael, the land of the Jews. When is he going to merit to make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael?
והיה לנו, אני עוד נסעתי למרוקו לראות, אני נולדתי שם, וגדלתי שם.
I was born in Morocco. I've already traveled to Morocco to see where I grew up.
נסעתי לשם לראות את הבית שהיינו גרים בו.
I traveled there to see the house where I grew up, where I lived.
והמסחר, בית המסחר של אבא שלי.
And my father's shop.
אני ואחים שלי נסענו לראות.
Me and my brothers, we went to see this.
והגויים שקנו מאיתנו את הבית,
the non-Jews that bought the house from us, they're still living there. They remember us and they bless us. My brothers were already learning in university and they did not want to make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael. I was one of the young children, I was only 12 years old. So I had no opinion in this. My father didn't listen or pay attention to anyone. My father said, what? We can make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael, that's what we're going to do.
באמת אני נולדתי בישראל, ופה בארץ ישראל, הגענו בשיקולים, כמו שהשלוחים הקדושים.
We made Aliyah and we lived here in Eretz Yisrael in some neighborhood that was allocated for Olim, some small disheveled place.
באבא שלי שכל ימי חייו, מה שנקרא, עצמאי, שסוחר מצליח.
My father, who his whole life was an independent, successful merchant, went to work as a simple worker in a factory. I can't even describe how happy he was. The main thing is that he is an Eretz Yisrael. And truly, he merited. All my brothers, if we would have stayed abroad, this is something that's not pleasant for me to tell, where my older sisters were at and where they could be today. This is something not pleasant. Something you can't speak about. Eretz Yisrael protected. And here we came closer to Rabbeinu, to Rabbi Nachman of Breslev. If you're a God-fearing person and your whole aspect in life is the essence of life, the purpose of life, you have no questions and no fears and nothing else interests you. I'm telling just about myself. I used to live in some village. I had a massive house. I had everything. I heard one talk from the Holy Rebbe. That he doesn't like it when Hasidim live in a small settlement in a small town. The night that I heard that talk, I told my wife, we are moving to the city of Bnei Brak. And she was crying, she was upset. She said, how can we leave our house? We have here paradise on earth. I sat and I spoke to her that we came to this world to work Hashem, to worship Hashem. If living in a small settlement, even in a big house, if it's not good and I cannot come closer to Hashem, there's no question whatsoever. And really we went to live in a rented house, etc., etc. If you have Yiras Shamayim, if you're a God-fearing person, you don't ask questions. And if you do ask questions, you will never, ever lose when you do things for Hashem. Never. Truly, with the grace and kindness of Hashem. Certainly, according to the plain, simple logic, the people who are living abroad and who asked the same question as you, Rabbi Gelison, asked, are right. Several times I said to Jews living abroad that it's worth your while making Aliyah. And those who don't do it, they suddenly find that their children are going out with non-Jews, that they're marrying non-Jews. And they come to me and I tell them, what do you want? What do you expect to happen?
Yes, Mishnah.
There's a Mishnah. Rabbi, if you have any more questions, with pleasure.
I have another question. Are you sure you want to hear my questions? I came to hear Rabbi Avraham Gislason.
Rabbi רוצה לשמוע את השאלות שלו. הוא בא לשמוע אתכם.
לא, אני שמח מאוד שהוא מתעורר לעורר את עם ישראל.
I am delighted that you are awakening in order to awake Am Yisrael to this important issue. Maybe through our merit speaking here in this shir, if one person makes Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael, this whole shir was worthwhile.
Okay, so
I have one more question, if Rav wants to hear it.
Yes, Rav, for the Shalom Rav, say Shmo.
We know that Rabbi Nachman and Rabbi Nosson tried very, very hard and went through extreme effort to go to Eretz Yisrael.
And they went, both of them,
and it was very difficult, but they made it, and they stayed there for a little while, and then came back to Ukraine. We know that Rabbi Nachman talks about over and over again the importance of Eretz Yisrael. Why didn't he stay?
Why didn't Rabbi Nachman stay in Israel? They arrived to Eretz Yisrael with incredible miracles.
אם שאלה לקחת אישה בילדים, להביא אותם את כל הסכנות שהם עברו, את כל היסורים שעברו, ממש, ממש, ממש.
It wasn't like today that it's so easy to come. There were such perils and dangers coming to Eretz Yisrael. They couldn't even take their wives and take their children to Eretz Yisrael because it was so dangerous, so crucial and so difficult to come to Eretz Yisrael in those times.
ודאי עליהם, כל כך היה להם חשוב
Certainly, להיות, it was so important for them
ישראל,
to be in Eretz Yisrael.
אפילו, קצת אפילו.
Even for a little amount of time.
לכן הם ממש סיכנו את החיים שלהם.
That's why they put their lives in danger just to come to Eretz Yisrael.
כפשוטו היה סכנת חיים.
They literally put their lives in danger. It was a life-dangering situation to come to Eretz Yisrael.
אבל ודאי שלא יכלו להעלות את המשפחות שלהם בפרט ש...
But they were unable to bring their families with them to Eretz Yisrael.
בפרט שפה בארץ ישראל עדיין לא היה בקושי איזה... לא היה עדיין כלום כמעט, כלום פה.
Especially because here in Eretz Yisrael there was barely any Jewish settlement. There was nothing here in Eretz Yisrael.
קושי היה משהו, משהו.
It was barely anything.
אז זה... לכן הם... אז... אדרבה, זה הנקודה, תגיד איך הם סיכנו את החיים שלהם שלהגיע אפילו לכמה זמן.
And that's why they returned. On the contrary, that's the point that we have to specify, that we have to emphasize, that they endangered their lives to come to Eretz Yisrael even for a small amount of time.
וכמה זמן לקח להם להגיע לכם.
And how long it took them to come to Eretz Yisrael.
כמעט חצי שעה או יותר.
Nearly half a year, if not more.
זה לא 4 שעות טיסה.
It's not a 4-hour flight.
Short shaila ממישהו פה.
כן.
Someone else asked, here, I'm just contacting here, thank you so much for the amazing opportunity from Toronto.
תודה לזה,
תודה
נפלא.
Having the Rav here, thank you, Rav Avraham, being a light for us.
תודה רבה, רבי אברהם גליסון.
Our good friend Yochanan from Toronto
וחברנו יוחנן מטורונטו רוצה לשאול.
The Bnei Anusim.
בני אנוסים.
What can we do to help them?
מה אפשר לעזור לבני אנוסים?
One more question is, well, some feedback here is, Shalom, dear Rav Shalom Arush, Rav Dayan Elgrod. Hashem bless you all in Breslev, Israel, Breslev, UK. I have a question, what can we do as Noachites to engage all our Noah and Bnei Yisrael?
מה אפשר לעשות בתור בני נוח כדי לחבר ולשלב בני נוח
from Toronto says, how can we bring about the Gula quickly?
ועוד מישהו מטורונטו שואל, איך אפשר לזרז את הגאולה?
יפה. קודם כל, באמת, אנחנו מודים לשם שזה יש לנו חלק גדול בלקרב את בני נוח.
Firstly, I'd like to thank Hashem that we have a great part in bringing the Noahites closer to Hashem. We're always in connection with the Noahites. In different forms, we sent them books. That is what everyone should do. Bring the Noahites closer. That gives a lot of strength and power to Am Yisrael. The mere fact that they believe in Hashem and they believe in the Torah given to us by Moshe Rabbeinu and they love Am Yisrael,
אז זה
that enlightens the world and gives power to Am Yisrael. So truly, what can we do to bring the redemption, the Geula, closer? Two things. The first thing it says in the Holy Zohar, I have here the Holy Zohar. The Holy Zohar says that when there's judgment in the world, when the world is going through a difficult time, especially Am Yisrael, the Zohar says, woe unto that generation that doesn't have Moshe Rabbeinu living in that generation. Why? Because Moshe Rabbeinu, every single difficult decree on Am Yisrael, he used to abolish it through his prayers. He used to stand and pray and pray and pray until the gezeira, the decree, disappeared. And that's why woe unto the generation that Moshe Rabbeinu is not living in it. Therefore, I decided I do this in Eretz Yisrael in a large scope. That every single person will be Moshe Rabbeinu.
Katan.
A little Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu used to daven for 40 days and nights straight without any break. We're asking for every single person to daven for 10 minutes only for Am Yisrael. The more Jews that we have that daven for 10 minutes a day on Am Yisrael, we'll have hundreds of thousands of minutes in a day. So we're already starting to be similar to Moshe Rabbeinu. What do we need to daven for when we daven for Am Yisrael? That Hashem will give them full and complete emuna, full and complete faith. That they will have the books. They will learn in the books. They will come closer to the work of praying and isbodedus, of speaking to Hashem in your own language. We need to say to Hashem, Hashem, what do you want? Poor Am Yisrael, they don't understand. They don't have the understanding and knowledge. You must give them books and materials so they can learn and come closer to you, Hashem. 10 minutes a day only, pray for Am Yisrael to repent, to do tshuva. That they will merit to repent completely without any agony or difficulty. And you can repeat the words and repeat the words again and again for 10 minutes a day only. The second thing, I'm embarrassed to say this, because people think that I am a very vain and proud person. But what can I do? The books that Hashem wrote through me, a person just touches them and already his life changes for the better. One has to distribute these books. Everyone has to make an effort and distribute these books. It says in Likutei
Halachas,
I said this last week,
that
that when people will distribute the books that teach people the wisdom and the knowledge of the righteous people, is greater than building Beis
HaMikdash.
It is greater than building shuls. It is greater than writing a holy scroll of the Torah. The greatest charity a person can give is in order to distribute his books. And he says that's what it says, that his righteousness will stand in his merit forever. So if everyone would awaken to distribute his books, Hashem merited me now to write a small pamphlet that is called The Law of Gratitude. It's already translated into English and into Spanish. Anyone who learns this pamphlet, he starts saying thank you even for the worst thing that happened to him. And Rabbi Natan said that if people would say thank you for the good and for the bad, certainly all the troubles and difficulties would be cancelled and abolished, and all the exiles would disappear. And a long time ago, Mashiach
Tzidkenu
would have come. So we now have a pamphlet that every one of Am Yisrael must have this pamphlet. The pamphlet, it cost pennies. You buy 1,000 of these pamphlets. We're talking here about a small amount of money, pennies. Everyone, call up and order at least 100, 200 of these pamphlets and distribute them. Those are the two things one has to do. Smile. Yes, we need to pray for Am Yisrael. And at least this pamphlet, at least this little booklet, it's a small booklet the size of a tikkun haklali. That people should have it and should learn it and should say thank you. And Mashiach will come.
Avra Alter in Toronto is a very good address for anyone. Her phone number's on the flyer. Avra Alter in Toronto. She can organize it very easy for all the Toronto community. They can come to the Breslev store, breslev.co.il, and they can order as many as they need, and we'll ship it out as soon as possible. Happy to help from the store, breslevstore.co.il. That's it.
I also understand that on the broadcast itself, you can see the number, you can see all the details. Yes. It's written on the phone screen, phone number, the websites, how you can reach us, how you can order these booklets, these pamphlets of the Law of Gratitude and distribute them to people all over the world.
Someone reached out from New York. And so thank you for this year. That's where we'd like to be next week. Hanukkah, I'd say. We'd like to be in Chazak, please God. And after Hanukkah, we'd like to go again to thank you, Hashem. We did a great Motzi Shabbos in New York. We'd like to do that again online. And this is something which all of your communities can reach out to us. The same information, and we can do this online with the meetings before and after, and have host a Rav from the community like Rav Avram. We appreciate him being there with us. And look at the beautiful Toronto scenery behind. I mean, it's fabulous. Thank God. What a beautiful city. Okay, next. Mashiach and Aliyah. People are asking, you know, what about how quick is it going to come? Like, because all the challenges going on in the world,
Europe and America.
The Rav spoke about this Rosh Hashanah time.
Rav דיבר על זה בראש השנה, על משיח.
אז לדבר, אפשר לדבר.
To speak, we can speak.
But
we want to do actions to bring Mashiach, not just to speak. I teach my students that every single mitzvah I do, even when I make the blessing of Asher Yotzar, I say that through the merit of this mitzvah, Mashiach Tzidkenu will come. Every prayer, every mitzvah and commandment that I do, every Torah that I learned, even before I started the shiur today, I say that through the merit of what I'm doing, Mashiach will come. Everyone needs to be alert through the whole day, praying and asking for Mashiach to come. The minute everyone wants Mashiach, that is Mashiach. Really and truly, the situation is very difficult. I don't like to be a person who gives over bad
news.
I know and I live what Am Yisrael are going through. Every single day, more troubles and difficulties are revealed to me. For more than 40 years, I'm saying shiurim. I have yeshivas. What I went through this year with Am Yisrael, I didn't go through for the whole 40 years. Not even the whole year round, just this week. That's why we want everyone to awaken, to make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael, to daven for Am Yisrael, to distribute these booklets, these pamphlets, to do everything in your power. And all day long, think, be alert, and pray that Mashiach will come. Every single mitzvah, commandment that you do, say that you're doing it for Mashiach to come.
Wow, so,
can I ask another question?
Yes, please.
Yeah, you can hear me? I got a new headphone, so I make sure you can hear me.
Wonderful. The
Rav said, you know, these beautiful things we can do to spread out the Sfarim. And
thank Hashem,
to talk to Hashem, to pray, and to make Aliyah. The question is, if you have a person who the Rav said, someone who has Emuna,
אדם שיש לו אמונה, אדם שיש לו יראת שמיים, שלא יהיה לו שום שאלה, ויהיה מסוגל לעבור לארץ ישראל ולא לדאוג על פרנסה, לא לדאוג על חינוך ילדים, לא לדאוג על כל הדברים מסביב שאנשים דואגים אליהם. אם אדם הוא לא במדרגה הזאת של יראת שמיים, ואין לו אמונה מספיק חזקה, איך אנחנו מגיעים לשם, להגיע לאמונה הזאת וליראת השמיים? מה צעדים כדי שנוכל לחיות עם אמונה ויראת השם? שנוכל באמת להתמודד עם המצב המפחיד והמאתגר.
קודם כל, חייבים להציל, לפרסם. צריכים לפרסם.
First of all, we must publish, we must advertise.
בארץ ישראל יש כבר קהילות של כל מיני...
that in Eretz Yisrael we already have communities of people who speak different languages, Americans, Canadians, French. They have schools
and
they're successful, thank Hashem. They've all managed to make Aliyah properly. we meet them, all of them have managed to make life themselves in Eretz Yisrael. And when they came, they were the first ones that came, they had nothing. And now there's everything. This is not like when Am Yisrael went with Moshe Rabbeinu into the desert. And that's why the verse says, I remember to you the grace of your youth when you followed me to the desert through a land that was not sown. In those times, people left. They didn't know where they were going.
And
they had to come and fight and conquer Eretz
Yisrael.
Now, thank Hashem, we have Eretz
Yisrael.
And bli ayin hara, with no evil eye, they're constantly building and building and expanding. We have communities. And everyone here is eating. There's no one here who's famished. No one here is extremely thin. In Israel, everyone is dieting. Everyone is having a diet. There's such an abundance. Rabbi Nachman of Breslev said that before Mashiach comes, there's going to be an incredible abundance. The food that people throw and cast away. So therefore, it's not as if you're coming now to a place. Thank Hashem, Am Yisrael are people who do a lot of chassadim, a lot of kindness and mercy.
Emuna, קצת ביטחון, קצת,
have a bit of faith,
תפילה.
A bit of believing in Hashem, having confidence in Hashem, a בלעשות. Bit of prayer. You're coming to do an incredible mitzvah. The angels that are created from this mitzvah are immense and enormous, and they accompany and follow you. That's why I'm so delighted and happy that you're speaking about this.
אנחנו לא מצליחים להקיף את כל ממש איזה זכות אדם מה הוא לקיים מצווה ומה
because really and truly, we're not even managing to encompass the greatness of this mitzvah. A person comes to do such a mitzvah. You can't imagine. Before the horrible Holocaust, may it never ever happen again. We know of great righteous people that warned Am Yisrael and told them, make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael. And those who made Aliyah and came to Eretz Yisrael, Hashem saved them. And they remain, they have families. And those that didn't listen, we can't even think, not only speak, even think about what happened to them. And even now, today, the righteous people, the tzaddikim are saying, make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael. There's no place that's more guarded than Eretz Yisrael. We say on Shabbos night, spread over us the tabernacle of your peace. Hashem spreads a tabernacle. There's a special guarding, a tabernacle of peace, which guards all of Am Yisrael and Yerushalayim. And Yerushalayim has two of them, one general for all of Eretz Yisrael, and the other one specially for Yerushalayim.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Somebody wanted to ask a very important question. What if the parents, for example, in Canada, this person's asking,
Canada,
aren't able to make Aliyah,
לא
but we all want to go home, what do we do about our parents?
כן רוצים לעשות אליהם, מה הם אומרים לעשות עם ההורים, שההורים צריכים להישאר?
אז אם הילדים הם נשואים,
if the children are married,
ויש להם משפחות,
and they have families,
אז מה, כמו שכתבו שולחן ערוך,
just like it says in the שולחן ערוך,
שולחן ערוך יגיד לך, אם האבא יגיד לך, תחלל שבת,
that if your father tells you, desecrate the Shabbos, violate the Shabbos,
אסור לך לשמוע,
you're not allowed to listen to him.
וככה כל דבר שיש בזה מצווה, אין שום, אתה לא חייב לשמוע לו.
And this applies to everything that is a mitzvah or that is forbidden to do. You're not allowed to hear your father when he tells you to go against the Holy Torah.
אומרים להורים, אנחנו אוהבים אתכם מאוד.
So one has got to say to the parents, we love you very much.
ואנחנו הולכים להיות ראשונים.
But we are going to be the first ones, the pioneers. With the help of Hashem, we are going to make a life ourselves. And then it will be much easier for you to come after us and to come
with
us. We understand you that you want to stay here, Lord. We can understand you that you're afraid to make changes. But we're young. And we're not afraid.
And
we're going to go, what? There are no planes back that can travel backwards and forwards from Eretz Yisrael to abroad? And anyone who comes to Eretz Yisrael, he will not want to return abroad. How many people do we know that don't stop saying thank you every single day for making Aliyah? And they came with fear. But now, after they made Aliyah to Yisrael, every single day they're thanking Hashem.
מה פתאום שלא נראה, אפילו בתור טיול הם לא רוצים לנסוע, אפילו בתור טיול לא רוצים לנסוע.
They say to me, heavens forbid, we don't even want to go back abroad, even for a trip.
Okay,
Rav Avraham,
it's tremendous chizuk to hear from
you. It's a chizuk nifla, listen to the Rav.
You're giving us your mayor, you're lighting us up and
giving
us chizuk.
Rav
madlik
otanu
v'noten lanu
chizuk.
Thank you very much, Kvod Rav. Yes, we need to hear this shiur again and again.
This shiur, one needs to play it again and again.
Avraham, we'd like you to end off the shiur with a final thanks and I don't know, Divrei Chizuk from the Rav, please.
Yeah, so first of all, I want to stress one more time.
Okay, a little bit of technical stuff.
To Rav Arush.
Yes.
What, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
I want to express one more time how happy we are to have a connection to Rav Arush and to Dayan Elgrod, and the chizuk that we get, the strengthening and the inspiration that we get from the Rav and the Svarim and everything, Mamish gives us a light, and like a light at the end of the tunnel. We're working towards something, and we feel this beautiful Torah and this beautiful inspiration coming from Yerushalayim. And I know that we all want to be there, and that we all want to get back there. So Bezrus Hashem will keep a connection between Breslev in Eretz Yisrael and Breslev in Toronto, and we'll make our connection stronger, and we'll learn more Torah together. Everybody should know that this class goes on every single Sunday at this time, approximately 1:30, and we can all connect to the whole world on this class every Sunday. And everybody should know, if you're in Toronto or Thornhill, that we have Breslev Thornhill over here, and we have a number of shiurim every week in Likutei Moran, and in the Parsha, and in Likutei Halachas, many aspects. And we should take the advice of the Rav, and we should do hafatza. We should spread out the books and the teachings of Rav Arush that are gonna wake everybody up to have Emuna, and wake everybody up to want to get closer to Hashem. And we should all say thank you to Hashem every day for every single moment of our lives. Say thank you to Hashem. And we should all, Bezus Hashem, daven and pray and ask Hashem that Mashiach should come. And everything we do should be a schus and a merit, that Mashiach should come right away. And we should all, be'emet, return to Yerushalayim, so we don't have to be on Zoom, and we can be all together, Bezus Hashem. Mm-hmm. One last thing. there's the new campaign that Avra Alter told me about, called Buy Just One Book, is going to be the new campaign. And like Rabbi Nachman said, when we learn Torah, in order to give it over to other people, the way we can do this is by buying the Svar and giving them out. Buy a book and give it to someone. Tell them how the Garden of Emuna changed the life of so many people that you know. Tell them how the Garden of Gratitude changed the life of so many people that we know. And by doing this, we are teaching other people. We're giving chesed to them. We're spreading the light of Emuna and the light of gratitude around the world. And as the Rav told us in this year, if we really want to get back to Eretz Yisrael and we want Mashiach to come, these are the steps that we can do, that we can undertake ourselves in order to make it happen. So I want to thank the whole Toronto community for sponsoring this shiur. I want to thank everyone who is behind the scenes, Avra Alter and her wonderful husband, and to Ellie and everybody at Breslev, breslev.co.il. We love you so much. We're so happy to have a connection with you. And let's make this connection stronger every single week as we go on. Bezrus Hashem. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Rav Arush. Thank you, Dayan Avra.
Amen, amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, studio. Thank you, everybody. That's it. That's a wrap.
Thanks.
We did it. We need to sing a song.